Sentinelese, the Sentinelese, also known as the Sentineli and the North Sentinel Islanders, are an indigenous people who inhabit North Sentinel Island in the Bay of Bengal in India. As North Sentinel Island is part of the Andaman Islands, the Sentinelese are considered to be one of the Andamanese peoples. They are designated as a scheduled tribe and are considered one of the world's last uncontacted people. There is significant uncertainty as to the group's size, with estimates between 40 and 500 individuals. Unlike other tribes in the Andamanese Islands, the Sentinelese appear to have consistently refused any interaction with the outside world. The Sentinelese are hostile to outsiders and have killed people who approached or landed on the island. As an isolated group, they likely lack immunity to common viruses, such as influenza and measles. For both the inhabitants' protection and the safety of outsiders, it is against Indian law to travel within 3 miles, 4.8 km, of the island. Overview of population. The population has been estimated at 15 to 500 individuals, with most estimates between 50 and 200. In 2001, the Census of India officially recorded 21 men and 18 women. This survey was conducted from a distance and may not have been accurate. 10 years later, the 2011 Census of India recorded 12 males and 3 females. That too was merely an estimate, described as a wild guess by the Times of India. The group managed to survive the 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake and tsunami, though it is unknown if islanders died as a result and what effect the disaster had on the population. Comparative distributions of Andamanese indigenous peoples, pre-18C versus present day. A map of uncontacted tribes, around the start of the 21st century. Overview of practices. The Sentinelese are hunter-gatherers, likely using bows and arrows to hunt terrestrial wildlife and more rudimentary methods to catch local seafood, such as mud crabs. It has been noted that they prepare their food in a way similar to the Unj people. The Sentinelese are not believed to have evolved their practices beyond those of the Stone Age. Metalworking, agriculture, and even the ability to make fire are unknown to them, although some sources dispute their lack of fire. They do appear to recognize the value of metal, having scavenged it to create tools and weapons, and their acceptance of aluminum cookware left by the National Geographic Society in 1974 is one of the few documented cases of their accepting a gift from outsiders. As the bodies of the two fishermen killed by the Sentinelese, as described below, were found, it has been suggested that they do not practice cannibalism. Overview of appearance and genetics. The Sentinelese are considered to be Negrito. They have dark skin and may be shorter in stature than average humans, with one report by Heinrich Harrow placing a man at 1.6 meters, 5 ft 3 in, tall, possibly due to insular dwarfism, the so-called island effect, nutrition, or simply genetic heritage. They appear not to wear clothing. Overview of language. The Sentinelese speak their own language, the Sentinelese language. Almost nothing is known about it, and it appears to be a language isolate. Since the islanders do not interact with speakers of other languages, there are no bilingual translators. During an attempt to communicate with islanders in 1980, researchers were able to deduce from words the islanders yelled that their language is likely unrelated to the Unj language spoken by the Unj people, who inhabit the neighboring Little Andaman Island. Additionally, it is not mutually intelligible with the Jaroa language, spoken by the Jaroas. With little new research available for anthropologists to review, the Sentinelese language remains an unclassified language. Contact. In the 13th century, explorer Marco Polo described the island's residents as a most violent and cruel generation and indicated that they were cannibals. Maurice Vidal Portman, 1880, in 1880. In an effort to establish contact with the Sentinelese, British naval officer Maurice Vidal Portman, who was serving as a colonial administrator to the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, led an armed group of Europeans to North Sentinel Island. Upon the group's arrival, the islanders fled into the tree line. After several days ashore, during which they found abandoned villages and paths, Portman's men captured 6 individuals, an elderly man and woman and 4 children. The man and women died shortly after or before their arrival in Port Blair, likely from disease, and so Portman attempted to befriend the surviving children by giving them gifts before returning them to North Sentinel Island, in hopes that the children would help village elders realize the British were friendly. The attempt was unsuccessful, likely due to the aggressiveness of Portman's visit and the fact that his efforts resulted in the deaths of 2 Sentinelese people. Additionally, due to differences in culture, the children might not have recognized the gifts as such. T.N. Pandit, 1967-1991. In 1967, a group of 20 people led by T.N. Pandit, an anthropologist working for the Anthropological Survey of India, travel to North Sentinel Island to explore the island and attempt to befriend the Sentinelese. They followed footprints into the forest, receiving no contact from the Sentinelese, and found a group of 18 lean-to huts made from grass and leaves and showing signs of recent occupation by an estimated 40-50 people, including fires, roasted fish and wild fruits, spears, bows, arrows and half-made baskets. On later visits, panicked boats were confronted by Sentinelese who turned their backs, which panic took as a sign their visit was not welcome, but they were able to leave gifts, which islanders came to take. He observed that the men carried bows and arrows, but the women did not. On one visit in 1991, the islanders took coconuts from the hands of Pandit's party, but would not allow them to enter the island. He reported that the Sentinelese talked to his party constantly, but he could not understand the language. Pandit took some onch to the island in 1991, but reported that their presence angered the Sentinelese. National Geographic, 1974. In early 1974, a National Geographic film crew went to the island with a team of anthropologists to film a documentary, Man in Search of Man. They were accompanied by armed police. When the motorboat broke through the barrier reefs, the locals emerged from the jungle and shot arrows at the boat. They landed at a safe point on the coast and left gifts in the sand, including a miniature plastic car, some coconuts, a live pig, a doll, and aluminum cookware. The Sentinelese followed up by launching another round of arrows, one of which struck the documentary director in his thigh. The man who wounded the director withdrew to the shade of a tree and laughed proudly while others speared and then buried the pig and the doll. They left afterward, taking the coconuts and cookware. The Primrose, 1981. In August 1981, the cargo ship Primrose ran aground in rough seas just off North Sentinel Island, stranding a small crew. After a few days, a reported 50 islanders appeared, threatening the crew. The ship captain broadcast urgent messages indicating that natives were on the verge of attacking the vessel with arrows and spears. Nearly a week later, the ship was evacuated by helicopter. Indian government, 1990s. In the mid-1990s, the Indian government set up a state welfare agency to look after the island's tribal groups and began a series of contact expeditions, which continued until 2000, when the programs were abandoned. Numerous expeditions were conducted, with the contact teams typically consisting of anthropologists, medical officers, government guests, and administrators. The Sentinelese generally did not let the contact teams get near them, and so they usually waited until the armed Sentinelese retreated. The teams would then leave gifts on the beach or set them adrift toward the coastline. Some of the expeditions ended in violent encounters. By 1970, India had staked its claim to the island despite limited contact with the islanders. In 1991, the first instance of friendly close contact was reported when the Sentinelese approached a dinghy carrying various gifts without any weapons and collected them. In the early 1990s, the Sentinelese began allowing boats to approach the shore, sometimes greeting passengers unarmed. But after a few minutes, the Sentinelese would begin to make menacing gestures and to shoot arrows without arrowheads. In 1996, the Indian government ended the contact expeditions after a series of hostile encounters resulting in several deaths in a similar program involving the Jarawa people of South and Middle Andaman Islands and because of the danger of introducing diseases. Deaths of two fishermen, 2006. On the 27th of January 2006, Indian fishermen Sundar Raj and Pandit Tiwari, who had been attempting to illegally harvest crabs off North Sentinel Island, drifted toward the island after their boat's makeshift anchor failed during the night. They did not respond to warning calls from passing fishermen, and the boat drifted into the shallows near the island, where a group of Sentinelese warriors attacked the boat and killed the fishermen with axes. According to one report, the bodies were later put on bamboo stakes facing out to sea like scarecrows. Their buried bodies were discovered 3 days later by an Indian Coast Guard search and rescue helicopter. When the helicopter tried to retrieve them, it was attacked with spears and arrows by more than 50 tribesmen who shot arrows to a height of more than 100 feet. The helicopter was able to lure the islanders to another location 1.5 kilometers away before flying back and gaining enough time to retrieve one of the two bodies before the islanders returned. During a repeat of the previous strategy, the Sentinelese split into two groups and prevented recovery of the second body. The mission was then abandoned and the second body never retrieved. Death of John Allen Chow, 2018. In November 2018, John Allen Chow, a 26-year-old American missionary trained and sent by Missouri-based All Nations, traveled illegally to North Sentinel Island, with the help of local fishermen, intending to make contact with and live among the Sentinelese in the hope of converting them to Christianity. On the 14th of November, Chow paid local fishermen in Port Blair to take him to the island. According to police, He started his journey after nightfall to avoid detection. On the 15th of November, Chow attempted his first visit by the fishing boat that took him around 500-700 miles from the shore. The fishermen warned Chow not to go farther, but he continued alone in a canoe to the shore, where the islanders attacked him with arrows. He later recorded in his journal that he had greeted them with Christian quotes in English and attempted to offer gifts, but they continued to approach him and he hurriedly retreated in his canoe. On further visits, Chow recorded that the islanders reacted to him with a mixture of amusement, bewilderment and hostility. He attempted to sing worship songs to them, and spoke to them in Xhosa, after which they often fell silent, while other attempts to communicate ended with them bursting into laughter. He recorded that they communicated with lots of high-pitched sounds and gestures. Eventually, when he tried to hand over fish and gifts, a boy shot a metal-headed arrow that pierced the Bible Chow was holding in front of his chest, and he left the island. On his final visit, on the 17th of November, Chow instructed the fishermen to leave without him. The fishermen later saw the islanders dragging Chow's body, and the next day they saw his body on the shore. The Washington Post obtained Chow's journal, which stated that he had a clear desire to convert the tribe and was aware of the risk of death he faced and of the illegality of his visits to the island. Chow wrote, "Lord, is this island Satan's last stronghold where none have heard or even had the chance to hear your name? The eternal lives of this tribe is at hand, and I think it's worthwhile to declare Jesus to these people. Please do not be angry at them or at God if I get killed." The police subsequently arrested 7 fishermen for assisting Chow to get close to the restricted island. The case is being treated as a murder, but there has been no suggestion that the tribesmen could be charged. Human rights group Survival International said it was possible that Chow had infected the tribe with pathogens to which they have no immunity, with the potential to wipe out the entire tribe.
About North Sentinel Island. North Sentinel Island is one of the Andaman Islands, India, which includes South Sentinel Island, in the Bay of Bengal. It is home to the Sentinelese, a people who, often violently, reject any contact with the outside world. They are among the last uncontacted peoples to remain virtually untouched by modern civilization. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands Protection of Aboriginal Tribes Act of 1956 prohibits travel to the island and any approach closer than 5 nautical miles in order to prevent the resident tribes people from contracting diseases to which they have no immunity. The area is patrolled by the Indian Navy. Nominally, the island belongs to the South Andaman Administrative District, part of the Indian Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. In practice, Indian authorities recognize the islanders' desire to be left alone and restrict their role to remote monitoring. They do not prosecute them for killing non-Sentinelese people. The island is in effect a sovereign area under Indian protection. In 2018, Government of India excluded 29 islands, including North Sentinel, from the Restricted Area Permit, RAP, regime, till the 31st of December 2022, in a major effort to boost tourism. In November 2018, however, the government's Home Ministry stated that the relaxation of the prohibition was intended only to allow researchers and anthropologists, with pre-approved clearance, to visit the Sentinel Islands. The Sentinelese have repeatedly attacked approaching vessels. This resulted in the deaths of 2 fishermen in 2006 and an American missionary, John Allen Chow, in 2018. Geography. North Sentinel is 36 kilometers, 22 mi, west of the town of Wondor and South Andaman Island, 50 kilometers, 31 mi, west of Port Blair, and 59.6 kilometers, 37.0 mi, north of its counterpart South Sentinel Island. It has an area of about 59.67 km2, 23.04 square mi, and a roughly square outline. North Sentinel is surrounded by coral reefs, and lacks natural harbors. The entire island, other than the shore, is forested. There is a narrow beach encircling the island, behind which the ground rises 20 meters, 66 feet ring, and then gradually to between 46 meters, 150 ft, 257 and 122 meters, 400 feet ring near the center. Reefs extend around the island to between 0.93 and 1.5 kilometers, 0.5 to 0.8 mi, from the shore. A forested islet, Constance Island, also Constance Islet, is located about 600 meters, 2,000 feet ring off the southeast coastline. At the edge of the reef, the 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake tilted the tectonic plate under the island, lifting it by 1 to 2 meters, 3 to 7 feet ring. Large tracts of the surrounding coral reefs were exposed and became permanently dry land or shallow lagoons, extending all the island's boundaries by as much as 1 kilometer, 3,300 feet ring, on the west and south sides, and uniting Constance Islet with the main island :347. History. In the 13th century, explorer Marco Polo described the island's residents as most violent and cruel generation and indicated that they were cannibals. The Onge, one of the other indigenous peoples of the Andamans, were aware of North Sentinel Island's existence. Their traditional name for the island is Chia Daa Quakriem, 362-363. They also have strong cultural similarities with what little has been remotely observed amongst the Sentinelese. However, Onge, who were brought there by the British during the 19th century, could not understand the Sentinelese language, so a significant period of separation is likely :362-363. British visits. British surveyor John Ritchie observed a multitude of lights from an East India Company hydrographic survey vessel, the Diligent, as it passed by the island in 1771:362-363. Humphrey, an administrator, traveled to the island in March 1867:288. Toward the end of the same year's summer monsoon season, Nineveh, an Indian merchant ship, was wrecked on a reef near the island. The 106 surviving passengers and crewmen landed on the beach in the ship's boat and fended off attacks by the Sentinelese. They were eventually found by a Royal Navy rescue party :362-363, an expedition led by Maurice Vidal Portman, a government administrator who hoped to research the natives and their customs, accomplished a successful landing on North Sentinel Island in January 1880. The group found a network of pathways and several small, abandoned villages. After several days, six Sentinelese, an elderly couple and four children, were captured and taken to Port Blair. The colonial officer in charge of the operation wrote that the entire group sickened rapidly, and the old man and his wife died, so the four children were sent back to their home with quantities of presents. 288. A second landing was made by Portman on the 27th of August 1883 after the eruption of Krakatoa was mistaken for gunfire and interpreted as a distress signal of a ship. A search party landed on the island and left gifts before returning to Port Blair. 288. Portman visited the island several more times between January 1885 and January 1887. 288. Post-independence. Indian exploratory parties under orders to establish friendly relations with the Sentinelese made brief landings on the island every few years beginning in 1967. In 1975, Leopold II of Belgium, on a tour of the Andamans, was taken by local dignitaries for an overnight cruise to the waters off North Sentinel Island. The cargo ship MV Rusty ran aground on coastal reefs in mid-1977, and the MV Primrose did so in August 1981. The Sentinelese are known to have scavenged both wrecks for iron. Settlers from Port Blair also visited the sites to recover the cargo. In 1991, salvage operators were authorized to dismantle the ship's :342. After the Primrose grounded on the North Sentinel Island reef on the 2nd of August 1981, crewmen several days later noticed that some men carrying spears and arrows were building boats on the beach. The captain of Primrose radioed for an urgent drop of firearms so his crew could defend themselves. They did not receive any because a large storm stopped other ships from reaching them. But the heavy seas also prevented the islanders from approaching the ship. 1 week later, the crewmen were rescued by a helicopter under contract to the Indian Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, ONGC. The first peaceful contact with the Sentinelese was made by Trilaknath Pandit, a director of the Anthropological Survey of India, and his colleagues on the 4th of January 1991:289. Indian visits to the island ceased in 1997. The Sentinelese survived the 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake and its after effects, including the tsunami and the uplifting of the island. 3 days after the earthquake, an Indian government helicopter observed several islanders, who shot arrows and threw spears and stones at the helicopter :362-363, although the tsunami disturbed the tribal fishing grounds. The Sentinelese appear to have adapted. In January 2006, two fishermen fishing in illegal waters were killed by the Sentinelese when their boat drifted too close to the island. There were no prosecutions. In November 2018, John Allen Chow, an American tourist and a self-styled missionary, was killed during an illegal trip to the Forbidden Island, planning to preach Christianity to the Sentinelese. Seven individuals were taken into custody by Indian police on suspicion of helping Chow's illegal access to the island. Entering the region with a 5-mile radius from the island is illegal as per Indian law. Fishermen told police that they had seen the tribes people dragging Chow's body around, but the authorities had not been able to independently verify his death as of 25 November 2018. The case is being treated as a murder, but there has been no suggestion that the tribesmen would be charged. Chow's journal indicated he was aware of the risks he faced, having been shot at by an islander with a bow and arrow on a previous attempted visit, and of the illegality of his visits to the island. In a final note to his family sent via the fisherman, Chow wrote, "You guys might think I'm crazy in all this, but I think it's worthwhile to declare Jesus to these people. Please do not be angry at them or at God if I get killed." The family has agreed to forgive the islanders and is not insisting on the return of the body to the US. Demographics. Further information. Sentinelese people. North Sentinel Island is inhabited by the Sentinelese. Their population was estimated to be between 50 and 400 individuals in a 2012 report. India's 2011 census indicates 15 residents in 10 households, but that too was merely an estimate, described as a wild guess by the Times of India. They reject any contact with other people, and are among the last people to remain virtually untouched by modern civilization. The population faces the potential threats of infectious diseases to which they have no immunity, as well as violence from intruders. The Indian government has declared the entire island and its surrounding waters extending 3 nautical miles, 5.6 kilometers, from the island to be an exclusion zone. Political status. The Andaman and Nicobar. Protection of Aboriginal Tribes. Regulation 1956 provides protection to the Sentinelese and other native tribes in the region. The Andaman and Nicobar administration stated in 2005 that they have no intention to interfere with the lifestyle or habitat of the Sentinelese and are not interested in pursuing any further contact with them or governing the island. Although North Sentinel Island is not legally an autonomous administrative division of India, scholars have referred to it and its people as effectively autonomous or independent.
About South Sentinel Island. South Sentinel Island is one of the Andaman Islands in the Bay of Bengal. It is 1.6 kilometers, 0.99 mi, long northeast to southwest and up to 1 kilometer, 0.62 mi, wide. At only 1.61 km2, 0.62 square miles, it is much smaller than its counterpart North Sentinel Island and of significantly less interest. The island belongs to the Port Blair Tehsil in the South Andaman Administrative District, part of the Indian Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Geography. South Sentinel is 26.5 kilometers, 16.5 mi, west-northwest of Little Andaman Island in the south of the Andaman chain, but 59.6 kilometers, 37.0 mi, south of its counterpart North Sentinel Island. From the limited information available, it can be said that South Sentinel Island is a forested coral reef. From a journal written in the 19th century, a Colonel Algak who passed the island road raised a few feet and continuous with the corals surrounding it. The island lies 186 kilometers, 116 mi, southwest from Port Blair. It lies immediately south of the passage. The island is 44 meters high to the tops of the trees and level topped. Its appearance is much the same on all bearings. A bank, as defined by the 36 meter curve, surrounds the island and extends about 6 miles NW from it. Considerable depths exist in the channel between this island and Little Andaman Island. Administration. Politically, South Sentinel Island is part of Little Andaman Taluk. The island is in effect a sovereign area under Indian protection. In 2018, Government of India excluded 29 islands, including the South Sentinel, from the Restricted Area Permit (RAP) regime till the 31st of December 2022 in a major effort to boost tourism here. In November 2018, however, the government's home ministry stated that the relaxation of the prohibition was intended only to allow researchers and anthropologists, with pre-approved clearance, to visit the Sentinel Islands.
Demographics: the island is uninhabited but is sometimes used by diving expeditions on account of its remoteness and novelty factor. Fauna: the South Sentinel Island Sanctuary, established in 1977, is home to coconut crabs.
Please subscribe Wiki Audio YouTube page below, and click notification icon to get future videos. Check out channel page to get more videos.